Hi guys, my name is Ashish and welcome to my YouTube channel. So the playdate edit is getting quite viral nowadays, so I created even one myself and I have posted it on my YouTube channel. You can go check that out. So today I'll show you how to create a playdate edit yourself so that you can also create one. So this is a beginner's tutorial. You do not need to have a prior knowledge of editing as such. Even if you are new, you can just follow these steps and you can just create it. So the software I'm using for editing is DaVinci Resolve. This is completely free software and you can download it. I will put the link in description. Now I'm in DaVinci Resolve. I've created a new project and now we can start our editing process. Before going any further, I'll give you a small overview of this software. So we have multiple tabs present here at the bottom. Currently we are in Edit tab. Here we can make all our modifications to a video, we can sync them together, we can put videos together, add audio to them, all kind of stuff we can do here. There are some other tabs like Fusion, Color is used for color grading, this is used for audio, and this is a deliver which we'll finally use to render our video. So currently we'll go to Edit tab. Now in order to create our video, first we need to import our sources, which would be the audio files, the video files. For that, what we can do, we can go to media pool. Here we can right click and go to import media. Once we do that, we can just go to our file location. Let's say I want to take our song. So once you import the file, it will appear here. Now you can double click on it to play it. So this has come here. Now what we want to do is we want to put this video into our workspace and so that we can play around with it. So click on this video, drag it down, and it will automatically create this timeline here. So timeline is nothing, it's just a workspace where we will do our editing process. We can add audios, we can add different videos here, we can stitch them together, and the whole editing process is done in timeline only. So our video is here now, so we can proceed with our further things. Now the first thing that we need to do is we need to find out where are the beats in our whole song. So what you can do is, first you can make this audio bigger from here, it will be easier then. Now we will manually play this song and just try to find out. Now what you have to do is, whenever you find a beat, you just need to press M. What it will do is, it will create this small marker there, and you can use this marker in your editing process. I'll remove this for now. So we will play the song. Yeah, so there was a beat here. What you need to do is, you need to go back a bit and press M. So it created a marker here, right? So whenever you hear a beat, you just need to press M. And what I'll do is, I'll do this whole process and see where I can add the marker. Now, once the marking of the audio is done, what we need to do is, we need to import our video files also. For that also, what we can do, we can just go to our media pool, we can right click, import media, and then we can choose our videos from there. Let's say I want to choose this one. Also, I will choose one more. This one. So in this way, this video will get imported and get shown here. Now what you can do is, you can just double click on the imported media, then play it. Let's say I want to have a video from this place. Now what I need to do is, I need to put an entry point. Press I.
Hey. Yeah. and then press O. So this will create an entry point as well as an exit point here. Now what you can do is, you'll see this icon, right? You can just press on this icon, hold it and drag it to your timeline. So it will come right here. You can just leave it and it will start to play with us. Okay. So let me align it a bit. Okay. So once you are done, similarly you can take your other clips also. So let's say from this I need to take this one. Drag this also here. Now what we need to do is, we need to play around with our video in order to give that effect to it. So what we need to do is click on our video, right click and then click on retime curve. Once you click on it, it will open a small window just below your video, and here if you click here you can see various different kinds of curves that you can see. So the curve that we wanna use is retime speed. Okay, so once it's selected, so this is a retime speed curve. Let me zoom in a bit. Okay, now what we need to do is, we need to play around with 4 frames. What I'll do is, I'll just use my arrow keys for 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 frames. Okay, so what I need to do is, first I'll increase the speed of this video. I'll increase it so this, you can use this option in order to increase the scale of your window. So now let me increase the speed of this video a bit. Let's try with 300. Let's play it. Okay, that's too fast. Let's speed it down a bit. Okay, so now we need to go front 4 frames. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now here what you can do is, you can add a key point here. So press Alt, then left click here, and it will add this key point here. So now what you can do is, in front of this key point, just drag down your speed to almost 70. I think 70 will be good. You can choose 60 or 70 also. Let's try with 65. Yeah, so it looks fine, but it's a bit speed. So what we'll do is, we'll just click on our key point. Then click on this option, which will make this curve linear. So it's bending it over too much. What we need to do is, we need to adjust our curve and make it a bit drastic. Yeah, let's speed it down a bit. Okay, so this looks fine. What we need to do is, now we need to go to our next marker that we have given, and we can, let's close it. Now we can cut our video till here. Okay, you can use this blade option. Click on this, just press it here. Okay, that didn't get cut well. Okay, just press it here. Okay, and now the video will get cut. So this portion, you can just press backspace or delete in order to delete it, and the video will get cut. Now let's go a bit forward. Now add one more video here. Let's say I want to take it in this one.
Hey.
Okay, take it from here. Okay, let's take this video. Press I. Okay, let's go back a bit. This looks fine. Press O. Drag the video down to our timeline. Now if you need to follow the same procedure here also, just click, right click on the video, select retime curve, select our speed frame. Okay, so here also you need to speed up your video. Let's speed it up to 300. So as you can see, it's going out of our scale. We can just drag, click here, hold it and drag, then it will increase the scale of this window of ours. So currently let's put it to 300. Okay, this looks fine. Then go back, go front 4 frame, 1, 2, 3, 4. Alt plus right left click in order to put a one key point here. Then decrease the video of the rest of the part. Let's decrease it till 60. Okay, this looks fine. Let's play. Okay, so we need to make it less drastic now. Let's make it a bit blurry. Okay, so this looks fine. Just need to make it bit drastic. This looks fine. Just increase the speed a bit here. Yeah, this looks pretty fine. Yeah. Okay. Now what we can do is, so in this way you can apply the effect to all your videos and you can get speed up and then sudden speed down effect from here. Apply to all your videos. What you can do, I'm just showing here with the two videos, rest you can apply yourself. So now the transition is looking good, but it's not looking that good. So what you can do is, there are inbuilt effects present in Resolve. You can click here, effects library, and here you'll find a lot of effects that you can apply to your video. So let's say we wanna let's apply a blur effect here. You can just click on the blur effect, drag it down to your video, and it will just get applied here. It's going over a bit too much, so I'll just go on the side and drag it down to decrease it a bit. Let's play it and see. Okay, and this looks fine. Okay. This way you can apply effects to your other parts also. You can use different kind of effects also. Let's say you wanna use dip to color dissolve. So dip to color dissolve is similar to the blur effect, but instead of blur, what you'll have is a small color that will appear on the screen. Now this one is set to white, so it's showing a bit of white color here. This you can customize also. You can select this effect, you can go to your inspector, and there you can select the color, whichever color you want to use. Let's say you want to use a bit of a yellowish color. Click OK, it will come like that. Let's play it. Okay, let it get rendered. So it looks pretty fine. So in this way you can apply effects to all the places wherever you want to give a transition. Wherever there is a beat, you can just apply a transition and just change the video in order to get this. Now this footage looks a bit flat. Now the next step would be to give this video a dreamy kind of vibe. So for that also we'll use some tools that are present in Resolve. What you can do is, you can go to effects library, go to effects, then there will be an adjustment clip. You can just drag it down here and you can just increase the size of it according to your requirement. Let's say I want to put it till here. Now what you need to do is, so adjustment clips help you to put any kind of effects that you want to put. If you don't want to alter your original video, what you can do is you can put an adjustment clip on the top of it and you can apply any kind of effects there. And those effects will be applied to our outcome that will get the whole video that will get, and it won't alter the base footage. So in order to apply effects on this, just click on the adjustment clip. Now go to your effects panel. What you can do is you can quick search here. You can search for glow. So glow will be in the open effects option. So go to open effects and search for glow, you'll find it. So this glow, what you can do, you can drag this glow here to your adjustment clip. So it will apply this effect. So currently it's not showing the effect. What you can do is you can select your adjustment clip, go to inspector, and then click on open effects. Once you click on that, you can see your effect present here. Now what you can do is, there are various parameters that you can modify. I'll try to modify the brightness that I have, because currently there isn't much glow coming here in our video. Just try to decrease threshold a bit, and this will increase the glowiness of our video. You can increase the spread also, so that it doesn't get concentrated at one place, and we can increase brightness a bit. Okay. So this looks pretty fine. Let's check at other places also. This looks pretty good. Let's decrease brightness a bit. It's too much here. Okay, this looks fine. Now, this is... One more thing you need to add in order to give that dreamy vibe to your footage will be... So, search for prism blur here. So, this prism blur will give you a bit of a blur in your video. Just drag it down to your adjustment clip. Now here in open effects only, earlier glow was there. You can just click on this down option and you will see prism blur also. Select prism blur. Okay. Double click on it and you'll be able to open that option. Now you can control your blur strength from here. So you can increase the blur a bit too much. Just increase it a bit, just to give it that dreamy vibe. Don't want to just hide the original footage and blur the whole thing, but just a little bit. So this looks pretty good. Here I think the blur is getting a bit too much. Let's decrease it a bit. 1.9. This looks fine. Let's try to run it again. Okay, this looks fine. So now this has the dreamy kind of look. We have our transitions set, we have our speed control set. So you can apply these concepts to all the other videos and put different videos in the whole song, and you'll have your plated edit. Now after applying all the effects, now you want to render your video. So in these tabs, go to the last tab, which is a deliver tab. So once you go there, you can see various different options here. You can select custom option from here. If you want to upload it to YouTube, you can just select the YouTube option here. So here you just need to give a file name. I'll just give it a file name of played it. We can browse a location from here. So if this location looks fine, click on save. So the locations will come here. Here you can modify the format of your video. You can choose, I will choose MP4. We do not need to mess with other settings. Resolution you can set here, and then you can use add it to a render queue. Once you add it to render queue, it will appear here. Then you can start the render from here and your video will come into the defined location.
Now you'll be able to make your playdate edits yourself, and I hope you got to learn something from this video. Thanks for watching. Drop a like if you liked the video. Please do share and subscribe.